For thus saith the Lord, behold, my people, I want you to go to a new level in your walk with me. I want you to understand what I am saying through Revelation chapter 2 and chapter 3, where I say seven times, he that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith to the churches. Yea, every year and every season, I want you to come before me and get your grades. Find out what I think about the way you're living, about what you're doing. Seek my face to discover whether or not you are in sync with me and if you are pursuing that which I want you to pursue. For I encourage you, those that are obedient, to understand that I list seven rewards for those that hear my voice and obey. In Revelation 2:7, I say, he that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. To him that overcometh will I give to eat of the tree of life, which is in the midst of the paradise of God. And in Revelation 2:11, he that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. He that overcometh shall not be hurt of the second death. And again I say in Revelation 2:17, he that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. To him that overcometh will I give to eat of the hidden manna, and will give him a white stone, and in the stone a new name written, which no man knoweth, saving he that receiveth it. And again I say in Revelation 2:26, and he that overcometh and keepeth my works unto the end, to him will I give power over the nations, and he shall rule them with a rod of iron, as the vessels of a potter shall they be broken to shivers, even as I received of my Father, and I will give him the morning star. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. Then I say in Revelation 3:5-6, he that overcometh, the same shall be clothed in white raiment, and I will not blot out his name out of the book of life, but I will confess his name before my Father and before his angels. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. In Revelation 3:12-13, I say, him that overcometh will I make a pillar in the temple of my God, and he shall go no more out. And I will write upon him the name of my God and the name of the city of my God, which is New Jerusalem, which cometh down out of heaven from my God. And I will write upon him my new name. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. And again I say in Revelation 3:21, to him that overcometh will I grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I also overcame and am set down with my Father in his throne. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. And my reward is with me to give to every man according to his works. Watch ye therefore, for you know not when the bridegroom cometh. And my people, I want you to change the way you see me. I want you to understand that I am the risen Savior. I am the risen Lord. I am fully God and fully man. And I sit in heaven on my throne on the right hand of my Father. Revelation 1:12, and I turned to see the voice that spake with me. And being turned, I saw seven golden candlesticks. And in the midst of the seven candlesticks, one like unto the Son of Man, clothed with a garment down to the foot, and girt about the paps with a golden girdle. His head and his hairs were white like wool, as white as snow, and his eyes were as a flame of fire, and his feet like unto fine brass, as if they burned in a furnace, and his voice as the sound of many waters. And he had in his right hand seven stars, and out of his mouth went a sharp two-edged sword, and his countenance was as the sun shineth in his strength. And when I saw him, I fell at his feet as dead. And he laid his right hand upon me, saying unto me, fear not, I am the first and the last. I am he that liveth and was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore. Amen. And have the keys of hell and death. Revelation 2:18, and unto the angel of the church in Thyatira write, these things saith the Son of God, who hath his eyes like unto a flame of fire, and his feet are like fine brass. I know thy works, and charity, and service, and faith, and thy patience, and thy works, and the last to be more than the first. Notwithstanding, I have a few things against thee, because thou sufferest that woman Jezebel, which calleth herself a prophetess, to teach and to seduce my servants to commit fornication and to eat things sacrificed unto idols. And I gave her space to repent of her fornication, and she repented not. Behold, I will cast her into a bed, and them that commit adultery with her into great tribulation, except they repent of their deeds. And I will kill her children with death, and all the churches shall know that I am he which searcheth the reins and the hearts. And I will give unto every one of you according to your works. For behold, my people, I am weary of your adultery against me. I am weary of you seeking other gods. I am weary of you loving other gods. I am weary of you seeking every face but mine. Therefore, understand that I search the reins and the hearts. I try you. I see what is within you. And I will give unto every one of you according to your works. I desire a church that loves me. I desire a wife and a church that is faithful to me. I desire a wife and a church that will hear my voice and obey my voice and follow me as I give loving authority. I desire a wife that will respond with loving submission. For the days do come where I will close the door on all those that are not faithful to me. The days do come where I will no longer tolerate those that are not committed to me. He that hath an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches, says the Spirit of the living God.